Good morning, students. In your last class, you have studied about cell cycle, and in this class, let us discuss about cell division. And in the cell division, today let us know about mitosis. So first, let us know about what is cell division. So cell division is a process that is a critical, dynamic and biological process which results in multiplication of our cells. So cell division, it results in a multiplication of the cells, and in unicellular organisms this cell division results in reproduction or multiplication of our cells, and in multicellular organism the cell division results in increasing the number of our cells that forms an organ or entire body. So by this we came to know about there will be the difference between the cell division between unicellular organisms and also multicellular organisms. That is, in unicellular organisms it leads to the reproduction or multiplication of the cells, but in case of multicellular organism the cell division results in increasing the number of cells that results in the formation of a organ or a entire body. And the cell division is of two types. First one is the indirect cell division. So indirect cell division, it is a type of a division of a cells which involves a series of sequential biological process, like the disappearance of the nucleus, disappearance of nuclear membrane, and changing of chromatin into chromosomes, movement of a chromosome towards opposite poles, reappearance of a nucleolus and also nuclear membrane. So it is a very complex process. For example, mitosis and also meiosis. And the second type is the direct cell division, and in this type it involves the division of a nucleus and the cell without any sequential biological process. So it is a very simple process, that is a direct cell division. And example for a direct cell division is amitosis. So in this case there are no definite stages like prophase, metaphase, anaphase and also telophase, and A mitosis is common in unicellular organisms like a amoeba. First, the nucleus is going to elongate. So in case of A mitosis, the nucleus is going to elongate and it become a dumbbell shaped. Further, the wall in the growth starts from the mid region. So in the mid region, the wall is going to start some kind of a growth, and nucleus is going to divide into two. So this is followed by the division of a cytoplasm, which results in the formation of a two daughter cells. So it is a simple process in case of a direct cell division. So now let us move on to the mitosis. So it is defined as a division of a cell into two identical daughter cells, each with a nucleus having the same amount of a DNA. So here two identical daughter cells are going to produce, and they are having a nucleus and they consist of a same amount of a DNA, and the same number of chromosomes and the same number of genes as that of the parent cell is obtained in case of the daughter cells. So mitosis is a most common cell division in case of both plants and also in the animals, and it was first explained by Fleming in 1882 and Strasburger in animal and plant cells respectively. That is, Fleming is going to explain in case of a animal cell, and Strasburger is going to explain in case of a plant cells. And mitosis is divided into four main stages, that is prophase, metaphase, anaphase and also telophase. So before entering into the divisional stages, the cell is going to undergo a rest period, and the rest period is called as a interphase. So in the last class of a cell cycle, you have came to know about the interphase. So it is the longest period in the cell cycle, and this interphase stage is going to show metabolically active process like functions of a proteins, RNA, DNA, enzymes and so on, and which are necessary for facing the future divisional stages. And the interphase is going to divide into three sub-stages. They are the G1 phase, S phase and also G2 phase. So now let us move on to the first phase, that is a prophase. So the complete sequential changes from interphase to the succeeding prophase, metaphase and anaphase and also telophase is called as a cell cycle. And prophase, it is a first stage in mitosis during a division. So prophase is the first stage, and the chromatin, which is in the network form in an interphase stage, is converted into definite rod shaped structures called as a chromosome. So the chromatins which are present in the interphase stage are going to convert into the rod shaped structures called as a chromosomes. In the beginning the chromosomes are long, at later stages in the late prophase these chromosomes become highly coiled and also condensed. So you are going to observe in the diagram, this is the early prophase and this is the late phase. So in the early phase the chromosomes are very long, and then in the later phases it is going to become a very coiled and a condensed structure, and the turgidity of the nucleus is going to increase, that is the enlargement of the nucleus is going to take place, and the chromatids undergo longitudinal division, and highly condensed and thickened rod-like chromosomes freely swim in the nucleus during the early prophase. So in the early prophase these chromosomes are going to swim within the nucleus, and nucleus is a clear in early prophase, but it is going to disappear at the late prophase stage. So compared to the early prophase, in the late prophase the nucleus is going to disappear, and nucleolus is present in the early prophase but disappears at a late prophase. So in the diagram you are going to observe the presence of a nucleolus in case of a early prophase and absence of a nucleolus in the late phase. And freely swimming chromosome move towards nuclear membrane, leaving a gap at the center. And finally, due to the dissolution of nuclear membrane and nucleolus, the chromosomes are shifted to the cytoplasm. So after the late phase, the chromosomes are shifted to the cytoplasm due to the dissolution of the nuclear membrane and also nucleolus. Nuclear membrane and also nucleolus. At the plant cell, the spindle fibers are produced at the end of the prophase. So in case of plant cells, these spindle fibers are going to produce at the end of the prophase. And in case of animal cells, the achromatic apparatus which consists of a centrioles, astral rays and also spindle fibers are produced. Then the chromosomes show setting connections with the spindle fibers. So in case of a plant cells and also in case of animal cells, there is quite differences what we are going to observe. So then is the second phase, is the metaphase. So it is the second stage of a mitosis, and in the beginning of metaphase, the chromosomes which are released from nucleus shows struggling and also zoosting movement. So when the nucleus is going to break down, the chromosomes which are going to show the zoosting movement, that is irregular movement. So this is to take equatorial plate arrangement, and this stage is called as a primary metaphase. So you are going to observe, in case of a metaphase, the chromosomes are going to arrange in a equatorial plane, and the chromosomes are highly condensed, short and also thickened. All the chromosomes are arranged on equator of a cell and forms a definite arrangement called as a equatorial plate arrangement. So in the metaphase, we are going to observe a definite arrangement of the chromosomes. And there are different opinions regarding the arrangement of chromosomes on the equatorial plate. And some people are going to tell that longer chromosomes are placed at the center and shorter chromosomes placed towards the margin of the equatorial plate. But the recent reports is quite different. So it is clear that there is no specific arrangement of the chromosomes and they shows mixed arrangement. So recent report has shown that there is no specific arrangement of the chromosomes based on the size, and they show the mixed arrangement. And the centromere of the chromosomes are arranged on the equatorial plane and arms are pointed towards the pole. So always the arms are pointed towards the pole. These are the arms which are pointed towards the pole. And when seen from the top, it is observed that the chromosomes of metaphase are arranged in the form of a ring, and that ring-like arrangement of metaphasic chromosomes is called as a metaphase ring. So when the cells are seen from the top, so it is observed like a ring-like structure, and this ring is called as a metaphase ring. So you are going to observe the metaphase ring. So further, the chromosomes are going to divide longitudinally and the number of chromosome is doubled. So when the chromosome is going to divide longitudinally, so by this the chromosome number is doubled. Then this doubling of chromosomes make the end of the metaphase. So next is the anaphase. So it is the third stage of mitosis, and the chromosomes which are arranged in equatorial plate starts moving towards the opposite pole. So when the chromosomes are going to break down or divide longitudinally, so they move to the opposite poles. And the equatorial plate arranged chromosomes are distributed. The chromatin apparatus is nothing but colorless structure which consists of a spindle fibers. In case of animal cells, both spindle fibers and astral rays, but in case of the plant cell, only spindle fibers are formed during a mitosis. So in case of animal cells, we are going to observe both spindle fibers and also astral cells. But in case of plant cells, only presence of spindle fibers we may Observed. So, we are in the case of anaphase, we are going to observe three types of spindle fibers. They are continuous fibers, chromosomal fibers, and also interzonal fibers. So, in the diagram, you are going to observe the continuous fibers. So, these are the continuous fibers. So, in between the chromosome, presence of interzonal fibers. And we are also going to observe the chromosomal fibers. So, the fibers which are going to hold the chromosomes, they are the chromosomal fibers. So, continuous fibers are the spindle fibers which are extended from one pole to the another pole. So, continuous fibers are going to extend from one pole to opposite poles. And the chromosomal fibers, these are the spindle fibers which extend from centromere to the poles. So, they extend from centromere to the poles and they help in pulling the chromosome towards the opposite poles, and these are also called discontinuous fibers. So, the chromosomal fibers are also called as a discontinuous fibers. So, last one is the interzonal fibers, or these are also called as interchromosomal fibers. These fibers are present in between the moving chromosomes and they help in pushing the chromosome towards the poles. And the interzonal fibers form a dense region which is called as a stem casper or pushing body. So, these interzonal fibers are going to form a dense region called as a stem casper or a pushing body. And the chromosome movement during anaphase is peculiar. Here the process called assembly and disassembly of a protein is going to take place. The spindles are primarily proteins and they are made up of number of monomers. And during chromosome movement, the interzonal fibers extend due to addition of assembly of monomers. Simultaneously, the chromosomal fibers, they are going to decrease in the length because of the disassembly of a monomers into the cytoplasm, and they are going to help in pulling the chromosome towards the poles. So, the spindles have a cyclic change in disappearance and also reappearance. Finally, the daughter chromosomes reaches the opposite poles at the end of a anaphase. So, when there is an end of the anaphase stage, there will be the formation of a daughter chromosomes, and these daughter chromosomes reaches the opposite poles of opposite poles, and the chromosomes appears like a different shape, that is, it may be of a V shape or a L shape or a J shape and rod shape during the anaphase. So, next is the last phase, that is the telophase. So, it is the last stage of the mitosis, and the chromosomes on reaching the poles, the beginning of telophase is going to form, and the cytokinesis takes place. Then the cytokinesis is of two types. So, first one is the centripetal cytokinesis and the second one is the centrifugal cytokinesis. So, centripetal cytokinesis is the division of a cell by the formation of wall ingrowth from the periphery towards the center. So, there is the formation of a wall in growth from periphery towards the center. So periphery to center, there is a formation of a wall. And the wall in growth meets at the center and divides the cell into two, and it is common in case of the animal cells. Second one is the centrifugal cytokinesis. So it is nothing but the division of the cell into two by the formation of a cell plate, which grows from center towards the margin of the cells. So in case of the plant cell, what is going to happen is the formation of the cell plate, that is, which is going to grow from center towards the margin. So it is quite different from the animal cell. So cell plate is going to form in the center and then it reaches to the margin of the cells. So the cell plate is formed by the combination of endoplasmic reticulum, vacuoles and also vesicles. And in the telophase stage, the nucleolus is going to reappear and the nuclear membrane also reappear, and the chromosomes undergo uncoiling and uncondensation, and then they are going to form a network like chromatin. So again, in the telophase, there will be the reappearance of the organelles, that is nucleolus and also nuclear membrane, and the shape of the chromatids are going to change, that is, the chromosomes, they are going to form as a uncoiling structures and they form a network like a chromatin. So at the end of the telophase, two exactly similar, both in morphological and genetical cells are going to formed. So this is about the telophase. So by this we came to know about the stages of mitosis. So next is significance of mitosis. What are the importance of mitosis? So it is going to play a very important role in increase or multiplication of cell in multicellular organisms. And in case of unicellular organism, so it results in a reproduction. So it is going to play an important role in growth and development of organisms of a body, both in plants and also in case of animals. And it also helps in vegetative propagation, where in some of the cases reproduction takes place by vegetative part like stem cuttings. So it is also help in a vegetative propagation. And it is commonly called as equatorial division, and it play an important role in equal distribution of the chromosomes and genes during the cell division. And the daughter cells formed by the mitosis are morphologically and genetically similar to that of the parents. And it helps in maintenance of consistency of a chromosome number during the successive generation. Thus, a constant structure of cell is maintained. So by this, there is no change in the chromosome number. And sometimes it results in abnormal division, or mitosis takes place, and this leads to the cancer, that is unlimited growth of the cell, and it is leads to the cancers. And it also play an important role in a study of a cancer. So these are some of the significance of mitosis. So by this we came to know about the cell division, in that mitosis and the stages of mitosis, and also the importance of the mitosis, that is significance. So in the next class, let us study about the meiosis. Thank you.